My name is Jenny. Today we'll be focusing on the lower back. So we're going to do a lot of exercises that strengthen the lower back and exercises that work through the glutes and your thighs that support the lower back as well. Remember, if you do have injuries in your lower back or in any part of your body, that you speak to your doctor before doing these types of exercises just to make sure it's appropriate for you. Also look out for the easier options, and then that way you can do what you need to do in these workouts. Okay, there'll be two parts. There'll be the standing element. There'll also be the floor on the mat as well. So we'll start with our breathing. We want to tuck our belly in. We want to tuck our tailbone in. We don't want to extend our ribs back. We want to be nice and tall through the torso. You want to breathe in, arms out. Exhale, curve forward, draw the ribs back. Inhale, breathe. Exhale, breathe out. Breathe in. And exhale, draw the ribs back. Chin towards your chest. Relax. Roll the shoulders back. Now, it's important that we move in all planes of motion. We spend too much time in our lifetime walking forwards, and we sit forwards. We don't do anything, or we do, but not enough in the other planes of motion to strengthen ourselves. So when you do reach for something, sometimes we can injure our back, or we can have a fall or do different things. So it's important to work in different planes of motion to keep strengthening those muscles. So today we're going to work in the three planes of motion, forward, side and back. And I recommend you have a chair if you have poor balance. So we're going to step forward, then out to the side, and then behind us. Forwards, side, and back. Now remember a distance between your feet, so then that way you don't balance on a tight rope. If you can, you use your arm as well. If you need your hand for balance, you keep it close. We're gonna come forwards, arms up, reach out. Reach back, arms up. Reach forward, up. Reach out. Breathing each time. Reach back, one more time. Remember, you can hold on. Forwards, out, and back. And back to the center. Think about your posture, shoulders back. Let's swap it over for the other leg. So we're gonna step forward, out to the side, and back. Keeping that distance between the feet so that if you're in front of each other, you'll wobble. So you want a bit of distance. Out to the side, and back. If you can, at the arms. Reach forward, out to the side. Reach back, arms up, forward. Side and back. One more time. Forwards. Nice and tall. And back. Well done. Come back to the center. I'd like you to have a handheld handy. So we're going to bring a handheld with us today, and we're going to use that. If you don't have a handheld, that's fine. You can just stand tall and use your arms out in front of you. If you do have a handheld, go grab one now. And what we're going to do is we're going to hold that handheld in front of us. And we're going to do a squat. We're going to take our feet a little bit wider. If you need to hold on, you can hold on. We're going to sink down and hold that tap out in front of us. Now when doing a squat, one of the most important things to do is where your knees are placed. When you squat, focus that your knees follow your toes. So if you turn your toes out just slightly, your knees should follow your toes. If they don't and you're looking like this, that puts a lot of pressure on those knees. Not a good thing. Out wide. Imagine there's a seat behind you. Bring your hips back as if you're sitting down on that seat. Arms out. Come back to center. One more, down. And come back up. Walk the feet in, take the arms up. Let's reach over. Breathe in, exhale. Breathe in, exhale. Breathe in, exhale. Breathe in, exhale. Come to the center. Relax your arms out in front. Feet this time are shoulder width apart. And we sit down on the seat. The knees don't go in, they follow your toes. Then we come back up. Sit down on the seat. Hips back, reach towards the sky, and then come back down. Stand up, reach out with your towel, sit down on a seat, breathe, reach up, breathe, arms down, stand up. One more, reach out, exhale, reach up. Exhale and stand up. Now, the last one that we'll be doing with the squats and standing is to take our feet out wide, turn our feet out slowly, hold the arms out and sit down. From here, I would like you to lift your ankles up one side at a time. This side, that side. This side, that side. It's important that your hips do not move. Just your ankles up, up, up. If you need to hold on, please do. If you need to be higher, you can be higher. As long as those hips are not moving. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax. Slowly come up into a standing position. We're going to keep our towel with us when we move down to the mat. Roll those shoulders back and breathe. Rest. So that completes the standing half. If you'd like to redo the standing half and make a workout of that, you can. Otherwise, let's head down to the mat and start the mat work. We're going to continue using the towel. We're going to sit with our shoulders back, nice and tall. You're going to hold your arms out in front of you. We're going to take the towel and we're going to roll back. Breathe. Then slowly come back up. Reach out towards the toes, extend the towel out. Breathe in, come up. Exhale, roll back. One more time, breathe in, come up. Exhale, reach out. As far as you can that way. Draw the hips back. Breathe and come back down. This time we would like to go all the way down to the mat. If you can. If you can't go down to the mat, completely fine, just stop halfway. Down. Place yourself one vertebrae on the mat at a time. Bring your arms up and over. Breathe in. Exhale, over. And peel yourself up off the mat, one vertebrae at a time, using as little as momentum as you can. Reach for your toes, like you're going over a beach ball. Come back, straighten up. Place your vertebrae, one vertebrae at a time on the mat. Bring your tail up and over. Come over again, breathe in. Exhale, roll up. Try not to use momentum, reach down towards those toes, over a beach ball. Last one, roll down towards the mat. Place yourself on the mat, one vertebrae at a time, and then relax. Now, we're gonna take our legs up. First of all, so that we've got our feet on the ground, our arms beside us and our shoulders relaxed. Bring our legs up into the tabletop position. We're going to place one toe on the ground and then the other. So we alternate those toe taps, nice and slow. One and the other. Tapping your toes to the ground. Breathe each time. Tap the toes down on the ground. Good. Now slowly place each foot on the ground. Reset so that your back is in a neutral spine. We're not arching our back up. We want to make sure that we've got our body in a neutral position. Bring the legs back up. And we're going to take one leg and toe tap that leg down. If it's too much strain on your back, then you can place your leg down and just use one leg. However, if you can, keep both legs up. Imagine there's a pillow and you want to push your foot through that pillow. Give a little tap through the pillow, push, push, good. Tap the ground, push the pillow, and then rest. Good. You will feel a little bit of strain through the back, but it is strengthening all those core muscles. Take both legs up and take the other leg down. Tap. Keep everything at a right angle. Relax your shoulders. Breathe. Three, two, one. And relax the legs back down. Very good. Take your arms out to the side. Take your legs over to one side and stretch. And take your legs up and over to the other side and stretch. Good. One more time. Up, breathe out, go over. Come up, breathe out and over to the other side. This is a really nice stretch, one that you can do when you wake up in the mornings. And it really opens up those muscles through your back. Slowly take yourself over. Today we're going to work on our stomachs. So this is going to compress the spine in our lower back. And that in turn will move the fluid between those vertebrae. And that will give you some relief through the spine if you do have a sore lower back. However, if you do have back pain, be aware of things that might make you feel a bit sore. So only do what you can do. Now we're gonna lie down and we're gonna focus on extending our legs. You can rest your head on your towel if you like, out in front, or on your hands, it's up to you. We're gonna take our leg, I'll move my hand just for the purpose of this video. We're gonna lift our leg up and we're gonna lift from the thigh. We're extending that leg through the wall behind us. So rest all the upper body and focus on your leg. You'll feel that through the back of your leg and through the lower part there. We're extending through that wall. Imagine you're pushing through that wall behind you. And relax it back down. Lift the leg up, extend through the wall, and draw a circle on that wall. Now the rest of your body is nice and still. And we circle that leg around. Try not to tense too much through the toes or you'll get a cramp in your toes. If you do get a cramp, just rest and start again. Relax the leg down. Lift and circle in the other direction. Round. And rest the leg down again. Okay, let's swap it over for the other side. Lift the leg up off the mat. Extend through the wall as long as you can. Circle that leg around. And try not to rock your body too much. Relax the leg back down. Reset. Lift the leg up. Breathe. And circle the leg in the other direction. Good. Continue breathing as you circle it around. And lower it back down. Okay. Now, lift both legs up off the ground. And we're lifting from our thighs. So we're trying to get those thighs off the mat. You might not be able to, but you can attempt to. Lift and hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, relax. Lift and hold, 5, 4, 3, two, one, relax. Now, just to add a little bit more challenge, remember you can do one leg if you can't do two. If you can do two legs, lift both legs and tap those ankles together. Like Dorothy, no place like home. Tap, tap, tap. Tap those ankles together. Five, four, three, two, one, and rest. We're going to take those arms out beside us, lay them down beside us. We're going to look towards the mat. Look at that towel in front of you. Lift your arms and your legs up, and we're compressing through that lower part of the spine. Tuck that chin in and hold. Breathe and relax. If you can, bring your arms out in front of you. Lift, hold, and alternate the arms and legs and swim. So it's like you're swimming in a pool. Up, down, five, four, three, two, one, and rest. Now bring your arms up, bring yourself over, bring yourself all the way back. Extend your arms as far forward as you can. Curve your back, head down, slowly come up. Step yourself up into a standing position. We're going to go side to side just to loosen the back. Breathe. We're going to bring ourselves down towards the ground to stretch. And come back to center. That concludes our session on the lower back. I hope you enjoyed it today. Thank you.